Mr. President, how do you do?
Mr. Minister, how do you do?
Ambassador?
Yes.
Deputy Foreign Minister?
How do you do?
Nice to see you.
Mr. President?
Hello.
Mr. Fukada?
Hello there.
Minister?
George Bush, nice to see you.
Vice President?
Hello, my friend, you're back, nice to see you. Another friend, nice to see you, sir.
Hiya.
Where are you?
Get a little pan down there.
How you doing?
Hi, Mr. President.
How are you?
See you, we see this very quick.
Mr. President, thank you first of all for receiving me despite a very hard and tight schedule. I much appreciate this opportunity. And also I'd like to congratulate you and the American people for the success of the Columbia, which I just watched over today.
Commissioner Pill?
Mr. President?
Commissioner Segoria? Commissioner Sloan? And Commissioner Sitt?
Hello there. And all of you. Good morning. Pleased to welcome all of you here to commemorate the 21st anniversary of the National Poison Prevention Week that was sponsored by the Consumer Product Safety Commission and the Poison Prevention Week Council. We've made great progress for the last two decades in reducing death and injury to young children, particularly from medicines and household products within the home. The efforts of a great many of you have been required. Over the years, consumers and health professionals, industry, and government have worked toward a common goal. And the extent of your partnership this year is particularly commendable. It's the kind of approach this administration wholeheartedly supports. I'm pleased that there are representatives here, 29 organizations of the Poison Prevention Week Council mark this occasion. The individual programs, the accomplishments of each of your organizations long contributed to the reduction of accidental poisonings. And Nancy, one of this administration's high-level appointees, I want to compliment you and your able leadership of the Consumer Product Safety Commission. Your commitment to safety and to the American public, work with the private sector to seek the most effective and responsive methods for reducing these hazardous and unsafe products is to be applauded. And congratulations to all of you for the work that you are doing. I wish you continued success with this program, and know the great importance as you do of what it means to the families and people across this land. I can't help but tell a little thing, and this isn't to suggest that there is something additional you should be doing, but I just thought you might be interested, and maybe this is more widespread than I know, as Californians are a little provincial, but not too long before coming here, I learned that in California, there is a doctor at a children's hospital, and outside that hospital, he has a garden of death. And his parents come to visit their children, and he takes them out there, and he has created a garden in which all the things that might be found around in shrubbery and in flowers and so forth that actually are poisonous, such as the castor bean from the castor tree. Mike Deaver knows about that. He turned around one day just in time to see his baby son swallowing castor bean. And just that accidental sight meant the life of the child as he got him inside. But I just thought that you, with all that you're doing, might be interested in hearing of this unique and innovative way of telling parents that, you know, I think everyone in California's got a few oleander bushes around. And that can actually be so poisonous that there is on record the case of a death someone who simply took a limb off one of those trees and sharpened it to use it a wiener roast, roasting wieners, and died from the poison from that one limb. But again, I just want to thank all of you here, and I know that someone wants some pictures. How are we going to do this here?
I'd like Commissioner, yes, Commissioner Hayes and Food and Drug Administration.
My pleasure, sir. I come with a small reminder of FDA's interest in your personal well-being. That's for
75 years of protecting jelly beans. And they'll get individuals if come by.
Yep. Not all of them, most of them.
Well, I appreciate all your
presence and honor.
See you.
I give the Salt Lake Drug Association and chairperson of the Poison Prevention and Council.
No problem for those cookies.
No, thank you.
Dental Association, Asher Shavora, and one of the other orthodontists, like Spike. I'm still waiting for the check. Check. Reminder.
You'll put a nice well, see you.
I'm Dr. Weaver from the American Colloid Institute, and we appreciate your support in this important endeavor.
Appreciate all the help.
Mr. President,
I won't say that. We really need more jelly beans, Mr. President.
Good morning, Mr. President. Stone Art,
Pennsylvania. I was just trying to ask what our ideas were saying. I was just trying to ask it out of your
Mr. President, Charles Obama. We also run a poison control center in Washington.
His first request was he wanted to put a tag on each one of the jars of jelly beans in there and immediately wash and rinse. Hey, listen, well, gentlemen, good luck.
Mr. President, on behalf of the Consumer Product Safety Commission and the Poison Prevention Week Council, we say a very special thank you to you. This, or 25 national organizations represent 9 million people, and this week we will be working for poison prevention. We are delighted to have the support of you and the world.
So long.
Excited.
For heaven's sake, Max, it's good to see you. My golly.
Mr.
well in the figure. You take that chair over there for a while and I'll go back to Bermuda.
Close it 2 months, get some 10 minutes.
Yes. Hey, that's great. Well, sit down. We've missed you.
Thank you. I missed you.
Thank you, sir.
Jimmy Williams.
How are you? Very nice. I'm sorry, sir.
Jimmy
Williams, did you meet Mr. Patterson?
See you.
Hi, Mr. President.
Well, I want to thank you all for the time that you've devoted to this federalism issue. I remember a meeting we had in this very same room on December 15, 1981. And many of the suggestions which were received that day reflected in a conceptual framework that we announced on January 26th, that there must be large, bold program rather than, in the words of Governor Snelling, just a piecemeal attack on federalism. The need for the true sorting out of responsibilities among the various levels of government. I remember Pete Domenici talking about increasing the revenue share dramatically. Well, in a sense, that $28 billion trust fund is a giant revenue sharing program for the states and localities. And there's the need for the pass-through of the funds to local units of government. And I guarantee you that that mandatory pass-through will be a part of this package. The need for a match between revenues turned back and programs of sort is important. And this is part of the proposal that we'll provide for. A dollar-for-dollar match of revenues and programs. And we'll continue the structural proposal so that no winners, no losers will be found among the states. And finally, we've responded to the request that there'd be an adequate transition, not making the program fully effective until fiscal year 1991. Well, your timing of the meeting today, I think, was perfect. We haven't nailed down the details of our proposal yet, but the issues have been sufficiently crystallized by now that your input can be very effective. I know there's some concerns about full state assumption of the AFDC and the food stamps. We're willing to look at alternative swaps in the income maintenance area. We want your guidance on pass-through. And we're willing to look for other revenue sources in place of the windfall profit tax. We need your advice on the 43 programs that would be turned back. In short, we're eager to listen. This is the first opportunity that I've had since January 26th to sit down with representatives of all levels of government, and I look forward to hearing from you in this particular session. Paul, before we open up the discussion, though, I want to express special thanks to you for your leadership in this important committee. I knew when I asked you to chair this committee that you shared my strong feelings on the importance of returning power and authority to the state and local government, to the people. You've done a great job. I appreciate it. And now, it's your turn.
I thank you, Mr. President. I might say that we had another very productive meeting, and the more that I associate with this group of people, the more impressed I am. If you had to go out and handpick this country in terms of filling the bases on the local, county, city, state, and federal levels, you couldn't do better than with this handpicked group.